السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله
لا إله إلا الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، my dear beloved respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gathered us in this masjid, to gather us yawm al-qiyamah, wa sayyid al-mursaleen Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ya rabbal alameen. My brothers and sisters, a fact that we are in this dunya to be tested. This is a fact. And sometimes we forget. So inshaAllah ta'ala, I ask Allah to make this khutbah as a reminder. How should we act when we are being tested? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirmed that in many ayat in the Quran when he said, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he is the one who created death and life to test you, who is the best in deeds. إِنَّ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ نَبْتَلِيهِ. We have created mankind from a mixed semen so we can test him. And many, many other ayat. And from the test, the true believer will shine. Because the test will separate the true believer from the fake believer. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسِ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Second ayah, Surah Al-Ankabut. Do you think you're just going to be called believer and you're not going to be tested? You're definitely going to be tested. طيب. What should we do when we are being tested? Five ayat that many of us memorize or have definitely heard them.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا.
Oh, who you believe. If I am a believer, I should become all ears. Yes, Ya Allah.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا.
Ya Allah, I have so many problems. I'm going through so many hardships. Ya Allah, what should I do?
يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة.
Present all your problems to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going through health issues, financial issues, problems at home, problems at work. Present them all to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What should I do, Ya Allah? Seek help with two things. Who's giving the remedy? The Creator Himself. Seek help with two things, sabr and salat, patience and salat. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا حزبه أمر فزع إلى الصلاة. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is distressed in any matter, he used to rush to pray. Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه was traveling and he came back from his travel and he was informed that his brother died. He got up from the camel, made wudu, prayed two rak'ah. Ya Ibn Abbas, you don't ask why, when, where, how. He said, didn't you hear what Allah said? Sta'inu bis sabri was salat. You told me I was patient. Now I'm doing the second one. I'm praying two rak'ah.
Istainu bis sabri was salat. Ya Allah, when I seek help with sabr and salat, what happens? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu istainu bis sabri was salat. إن الله مع الصابرين.
Allah Azza wa Jal is with the patient ones. When we do these things, Allah will be with you. Allah will be with us when we are going through difficulties. What does it mean that Allah is with me? When Allah is with you, it does not matter who's against you. When Allah is with us, He will switch the sickness into health. He will switch the poverty into wealth. He will switch the sadness into happiness.
As a matter of fact, Allah switched the death into life, and that is confirmed with the next ayah.
وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٍ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ.
And do not say about the people who died that they have died, the ones who died في سبيل الله, that they are dead. No, they are alive. Allah is telling us, when I am with you, I will make you feel even the death life. I will put something in your heart to make you content. Subhanallah. The ayah here is saying that even death will not feel the impact of death. You still feel that the person you left because of your iman, he's still alive.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us,
وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ.
We have agreed before that if we know simple Arabic, when the lam al-ta'kid and nun al-tawkid gets into a verb, that means this verb 100% no doubt is going to take place. And the khitab here, the speech here, is still to the believers. The speech here is still to Ya أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. I, Allah saying, will 100%, no doubt, will test you.
With what, Ya Allah?
وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ.
A little bit of fear. You cannot handle the whole fear. A little bit of fear.
وَالْجُوعِ.
A little bit of hunger.
وَنَقْسِمْ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ.
You will lose a job, you will lose a deal, you will lose a transaction, you will be fired.
وَنَقْسِمْ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ.
You will lose a brother, a sister, a husband, a son, a father. You will lose someone dear to you.
وَالثَّمَرَاتِ.
And the crops. ثَمَرَات. Some of the ulama said that the ثَمَرَات, you would lose the barakah in all that you have. One of these we will be tested by. Could be one, it could be two, it could be all. But definitely we are going to be tested. And then in the middle of these tests come this beautiful word, وَبَشِّرْ. وَبَشِّرْ, and give the glad tidings. Ya Allah, should I give the glad tidings to everyone who's being tested? No.
وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ,
and give the glad tidings to the true, to the true believers that are really patient. They're not just patient because, you know what, I have no other choice. I lost my father. What's the other thing I can do except being patient? No. They are being patient because they want the reward of patience. They know the reward of patience. يَحْتَسِبُونَ الْأَجْرَ مِنَ اللَّهِ. And they're expecting a reward from patience from Allah. When are they patient? Instantly. الصبر عند الصدمة الأولى. Patience is when you are first being tested. A text message, your house is on fire.
إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
Your phone call, your son had an accident.
إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
Ya Allah, who are these patient ones?
وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
Instantly, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We belong to Allah and to Him we shall return. Not after 2-3 weeks of complaining, then إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Why me? Why this? Why that? No, instantly. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Whomsoever is hit by a calamity, and then he says, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Allah will compensate him with something better.
قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
My brothers and sisters, we always say the statement. Have we ever thought about the statement? What does it mean?
إِنَّا لِلَّهِ. I belong to Allah. My wife, my children, my business, my home, everything belongs to Allah. And to Him I shall return. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will return. Now, if I come to your house every single day, I knock at the door, here's a check for $50,000 every single day for a year. Not one day I missed. Every day, $50,000 check. You put your kids in the best colleges, you bought the best house, best car, best life. One day I came inside to visit you and I opened the fridge and I took an apple. Are you going to be upset? Ya Habibi, take the fridge. Everything in my house is from you. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلِ الْأَعْلَى. And to Allah belongs the best example. Everything we own is His. He can decide whenever He wants to take it. It's all His. وَمَا بِكُم مِن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. No ni'mah that we have except it's from Allah. He can increase it, He can take it, He can keep it. It's all His. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Ya Allah, I prayed, I am patient, and I said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What is my reward? Listen carefully, my brothers and sisters. Ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim wa rahma. Wa ulaika humul muhtadun. Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, I ask you with the best of your names for everyone who attended today, everyone who's watching us, make us among these people, Ya Allah. These are the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will praise them in front of the angels. These are the people whom Allah will shower with His mercy. And look at the last one. And these are the truly guided ones. These are the truly guided ones. Allahu Akbar. So, my brothers and sisters, usually any imam leading the salat and he recites these five ayah, after Ulaika humul muhtadun, Allahu Akbar, he goes to ruku'a. Why, ya Sheikh? Because the ayah after that, the topic has changed. Now we are talking about Hajj. Because the ayah after that is what? The one that we all recite when we stand on the mount of Marwa, As-Safa. Inna As-Safa wal Marwata min sha'airillah, faman hajja al-bayta aw i'tamara, the whole ayah. This is the ayah right after that. Wallahi, there's no better place in the Quran for this ayah other than here. Why? What does Safa and Marwa represent? They represent three people, right? Ibrahim, Hajar, and Ismail alayhim salam. But what does that have to do with all the testing and all that? They have been tested with all five. All five. When Ibrahim alayhi salam took Hajar and Ismail and put them there and then he left. Let's go through the tests. Shay'in min al-khawf. Was there fear? a woman with a baby in the desert. Was there ju'a? Was there hunger? She was running, we all know the story of Zamzam running back and forth seeking some water for her baby. شيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال. Was there any money, any wealth? Even if you have wealth, what are you going to buy? Were there anfus? Were there people there? There's nobody, there's only them. Was there ثمرات؟ واد غير ذي زرع.
Allah said in the Quran, وَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ. There's nothing in there. There's nothing. But what happened? Because of that believing, pious woman, she said, Ya Ibrahim, how could you leave us here and go quiet? Ya Ibrahim, quiet. Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah order you? Did Allah command you to do this? He said, yes. فَإِذَنْ لَيُضَيَّعَنَا. Allahu Akbar. Allah will not waste us. Look at that patience. Look at that, all the others previously mentioned implemented. What happened? What happened because of the patience of this woman? Is there khawf in Mecca now? من دخله كان آمنا. Whomsoever enters is safe. Is there hunger in Mecca? No, no, no. Anytime a Hajji makes a mistake, he has to slaughter and feed the Meccans. Is there a shortage of people in Mecca? We know the answer, 365 days. Is there any shortage of wealth in Mecca? The most expensive real estate on earth, and the closer you get to that family, the higher the price. Is there a shortage of thamarat? Just the dates, there are 60 kinds. Allahu Akbar. Look at the position of that ayah. Kitabun uhkimat. The ayat of this book are perfect. Because of her patience and her perseverance and her fear of Allah, Allah switched everything for her. And same thing will happen to us, ya akhwan, when we are going through hardship. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Few things to remember when we are going through the test. والله يا أخوان, listen carefully please, because we come here to get a dose to keep us going. And every single one of us here is going through something, 100%. So what should we think about, what should we remember when we are going through the test? Number one, compare what Allah took to what He left. Compare what Allah took to what He left. He took your child. He left your whole family, He left your wealth, He left your health. He took your health, He left your beautiful family, He left you a shelter, He left you a business. Compare, you will find that what Allah left is way more than what He took. Number one. Number two, remember that the one who is testing me and you is Arham al-Rahimin. The one who's testing us loves us more than our own mother. He is the most merciful. He is the one who's testing me. The most merciful. He is the one who said that I will never overburden you with something you cannot handle. My brother, my sister, whatever you're going through, know for a fact that Allah knows that you can handle it. You can handle that sickness. You can handle that poverty that you're going through. You can handle that child. You can definitely handle it. There's no way the most merciful will test you with something you cannot handle and punish you for not handling it. We will not do this to ourselves. How can Arham al-Rahimin do this to us? Impossible. You can handle it. I gave up. I cannot take it anymore. No, you can. Just follow the right steps. The one who's testing us is أحكم الحاكمين. The one who's testing us is the all wise. Listen to this hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when Allah has previously decreed for a servant a certain rank in Jannah, and the servant with his actions does not deserve that rank.
I'm still quoting the hadith. Allah will test him in his children or his wealth or his health, and will make him endure the test and be patient to be elevated to the rank that was decreed for him. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. I was supposed to go to level 55 in Jannah. My a'mal does not lead me to the level 7. So Allah will test me with something hard and will give me the patience to be elevated to the status I was supposed to go to. So the one who's testing us is the most merciful. Remember that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved to Allah, he was born an orphan. He lost his mother, he lost his grandfather, he lost his uncle, he lost his wife. He lost all his children except Fatima. He was called names. He was forced out of his city. And this is the most beloved. Compare yourself to the best man ever. And you will feel like, you know what? Whatever happened to me, if this happened to the best man, who am I? Remember that when Allah loves someone, he tests them. That's the hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا ابْتَلَاهُمْ. When Allah loves somebody, he will test them. And the higher your iman, the tougher is the test. And remember that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah gives, open your ears, Allah gives the dunya to whom he loves and to whom he does not love. But he gives iman only to the ones he loves. My brothers and sisters, remember those two ayat that came after each other. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Allah does not have to repeat himself. With, not after, مع. With hardship comes ease. With hardship comes ease. So you are inside that hardship and you are so immersed in it, you're not noticing the khair. And I can give you so many stories just because of the time. You will notice many times that hardship that took place in your life, it turned out that the best thing ever happened to you. But at that time, you could not see that. There is always good. And remember that the test, and say alhamdulillah, that the test came in my health, in my wealth, but it did not come in my deen. You could die from cancer, die from a car accident, die drowning, die from corona, die from anything. Alhamdulillah, you could be even a shaheed. But to die and you do not pray, to die you have doubt about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to die and you have doubt there's a day of judgment, that is a musibah. So thank Allah that the test did not come in the deen. And finally, I always repeat that, subhanAllah. Anytime we're going through difficulties, we ask ourselves two questions. Two questions. Number one, does Allah know about my situation? And the answer is, absolutely. Second question, can he solve it? Absolutely. Done. Beg, Ya Rabb. Ya Allah, you are ala kulli shay'in qadir. And you are alim. You know what I'm going through, Ya Allah. You know, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbi. Facilitate this issue. Ya Allah, guide my son, Ya Allah. Guide my daughter, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant me a righteous spouse. Ya Allah, get me a job. Ya Allah, Jannah. Ya Allah, have mercy upon me. Ya Allah, cure my parents. Ya Allah. Listen to this. It gives you so much hope. It's a part of an ayah, not even an ayah. قال ربك هو علي هين. Allahu Akbar. Allah said, it is very easy for me. So anytime you're asking and you're feeling that $1 million debt, how could that be covered? Rabbi, ربك said, Allah said, هو علي هين. My son is giving me such a hard time. He's not praying. هو علي هين, to guide him. My daughter is not wearing the hijab. She's giving me such a hard time. هو علي هين.
I am trying left and right to get a job, and I'm having all kinds of difficulties. Huwa alayya hayyin, my mother's cancer, stage 4. Huwa alayya hayyin, it's easy for me.
Beg Allah Azza wa Jal, and you'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala غفور الرحيم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وأسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه. اللهم يا رب انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم أغث إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم أغثهم يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم. Please fill up the main hole first, foot to foot, shoulder to shoulder. Please come from outside and fill up the main hole. If you are in the two side rooms, please come inside and fill up the main hole.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا اعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Please, on your way out, donate generously to your masjid, and remember that the donation of Jum'ah is the best donation of the week. Two members of their family passed away. Our brother Riyad, his uncle passed away, and brother Ashir, his aunt passed away. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive their sins, shower them with his mercy, and grant them the highest place in Jannah. Please keep them in your dua. We have brother Ibrahim Isa, regular senior in our community. His wife is in the intensive care in Methodist. Please keep her in your dua. And also brother Wasim Salam, he's in the intensive care, also asking for dua. And also another sister just texted us right now that sister Hasna bin Hassin, she is sick also in the hospital, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure her. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفيهم. نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفيهم. اللهم يا رب الناس أذهب البأس واشفي أنت الشافي. لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم اشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. Few brothers and sisters also approached me that they are going through so much hardship. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease their pain. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to switch their sadness into happiness. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.